This is a brief compilation of the storm damage as it affected the London Borough of Bromley. And we're starting off with a shot in Green Court Road, Petswood. This is 2 weeks after the damage, and there are still a lot of branches lying around waiting to be cleared up. And in Church, Petswood, there's an early morning service going on. Losses to fences was very large as well, and most of it was uninsured by household policies. Timber merchants must have found it a very profitable month. Here's a temporary measure to hold up some fir trees. It was in Petswoods itself where the damage was most apparent. See the damage in Sevenoaks Way, Orpington. Advertising hoardings blown down. And these four trees all in a line have collapsed. Avenue, Orpington, was the scene of some of the worst damage from the storms, where six very tall elm trees lay across the road here 2 weeks ago. And the damage is still very apparent. You must have had quite a disturbed night.
Yeah, it goes the other way.
Yes, yeah, that's right. And they just missed the houses over the way there, didn't they?
Yeah, I mean, just tipped it.
Yeah.
A bit up in the slate.
If I had gone the other way, you would have needed your insurance, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Just briefly describe the what happened on the fateful night two weeks ago.
Yes, of course. You can see the devastation here. We moved to this area because of those lovely trees, but we didn't realise there was much of a threat as they have been. You can see that one has taken the top corner of the house off. One's gone through the new extension to the house. Two have gone through the garage. Seen a sheer devastation. The remaining trees, as you see, are very, very suspect. That one there, in fact, he's taken the load of the three they're leaning against it. And we're not too sure now we can go on living with this threat. The slightest wind now is going to give us the greatest concern.
Yes, and your coal's a write-off as well, I understand.
That's taken away a low loader, yes.
Yes.
It's a shame the trees must be, if I'd imagine, 100 years old or more.
Yes.
It's a terrible shame that we lost them. Have they really?
Yeah.
Yeah. That one went right through the bedroom, right through the roof.
Oh, I see, so actually...
Through the bedroom.
It was in the bedroom.
And she was sheer. Pardon?
It was in the bedroom.
Literally, yes, was it? I got some photographs inside.
Yeah.
But she was absolutely lucky that she'd just chosen to move out of that room.
Yeah.
Yes, I think that's about the worst damage I've seen up there.
Well, it is. Well, of course, what you've missed is that these trees...
It's in the garden, yeah.
These two trees here...
Yes.
The trees that severed that house fell from this house here. Oh no, no, I'm not suggesting that you have,
no. No, when you said, like, you know,
yeah.
No more damage. Didn't even break a paving slab up there.
Did you not?
This was all the damage.
Was in the house, yeah.
Yes, I
see. And the other two just sat up along the...
Oh, sort of rested on the side of it.
Wedged up onto that one. You can see there's a big mark on the side of that tree.
Yeah.
Which one of the boughs was
went round. So we took these, shortened all these back first and left the weights on the back.
Take long.
Back in the London borough of Bromley now, and this is an unmade road just outside Beckenham Place Park, which has been blocked off. This is the churchyard of St Giles, the Abbot Church, Farnborough, which, as you can see, has been badly damaged by the storms. This is Shire Lane, Farnborough, still shut to traffic 3 weeks after the hurricane struck. This is the junction of Shire Lane with the A21. It looks like this used to be a pond and filled with trees now, broken trees at that.